So you're an Ullrich man. Tell us a bit about yourself. Give us a background.
Just from Penrith. Born and raised in Mount Druitt, but from the last couple of years I've been living in Penrith. Fuck, taking on the rap game now. I dropped a clip a month ago. Music's here, it was kind of over here. I didn't expect it to blow up like that, but fuck, I'm on the right path now, and I've got some good things coming.
Yeah. What was your last song? What was the name of it?
It was 27.
27?
Yeah.
What does that number mean to you?
It represents the district 27, which is Mount Druitt and all the surrounding suburbs.
Which was where you grew up?
I grew up in a suburb called Wilmot, which is a suburb in Mount Druitt. But when I was a little kid, I grew up there, and I know most of the Mount Druitt boys and that. I grew up with them all, who are doing their thing to this day. And that's surrounding up to 214 and all that. But lately, I've just been banging on Penrith and repping Penrith. I've been doing the things there.
Yeah. How long have you been living out here in Penrith?
For 3 years now, close to 3 years.
Yeah, because I see that you got Penrith City tattooed.
Yeah, Penrith City, yeah. It's funny that the first year I moved into Penrith, I got that tattooed actually. But I've always been surrounded around Penrith and Mount Druitt and that. I've always hung out here, I know people out here. You know, it's not just a random thing to me, it's always happened.
Yeah. So yeah, bro, what got you into music originally?
Well, it's funny that I went to one studio session with Kid Curvey. I've always thought about it because I've hung out with a lot of rappers. I know a lot of rappers on a personal basis. And I went to a studio session with him, and I just loved how he done it. And I just love the whole fame side of things and how they operate and all the tools and that. I just think it's a good life to live. And I've been going to a lot of Cursor shows. Shout out to Cursor and Curvo as well. And once I seen their shows and the vibe about it, like, fuck, say no more, the rest is history.
Yeah. And Kid Curve, he's from Penrith as well.
He's from Cranbrook. Yeah, it's a suburb just next to Penrith, but yeah, you can say Penrith as well.
Yeah. Does he have a Penrith City tattoo in there?
Nah, he's not brave enough. Nah, he's a good guy, he's a man.
Now, how long have you known him for?
I've known him for a couple of years now. Yeah. No, he's a good guy, very good guy.
And how long has he been rapping?
He's been rapping since day dot. He started rapping when he was a baby pretty much. He came out the womb rapping. But he's been rapping since day dot. He's one of the ones who've taken it far. He's come from the ground up.
Yeah. Has you guys got anything together yet? Or?
We haven't got anything together yet, but we're meeting up soon. We're gonna have something together soon, also.
Yeah. And what about Cursor? What was that relationship like?
I was the best ever meeting Cursor when I first met him, because I've always listened to Cursor since I was a kid. Like ever since he was like started rapping out during my high school years now, I've always listened to him. It spins me out to this day that like I hang out with him and I go on tours like to his shows and that with him. It's a crazy lifestyle.
And would you say you make the same kind of music as Cursor, or what kind of music?
Yeah, definitely. I'm on the same path as Cursor's type of music. I want to follow his lead. Like, I want to do my own thing, don't get me wrong, but that's the type of music I'm aiming for, because we both grew up in housing commissions and suburbs and that. So we both are going to rap about that.
So you guys are kind of repping the struggle kind of thing?
Yeah, definitely. We're repping. I think most rappers from the area are repping struggle, because I don't know many rappers from the area who have always been like successful or rich. I think everyone's trying to rap about struggle.
Yeah. And Cursor, man, Cursor's a legend in Australia.
Yeah, he's the best they've ever done in Australia. He paved the way for every rapper in the scene.
He did.
There's not one rapper in the scene what can say Cursor didn't pave the way. It doesn't matter if it's drill, rap, like, you know, normal music, whatever you want to fucking call it, Cursor paved the way, because when Cursor was rapping, he was writing on notepads and that. He was recording on phones. Like doing little things like that. These days we're a lot blessed. We have YouTube, we have a lot of like, platforms to move on. He didn't have no such thing as Instagram and that.
Yeah. Since you're new to this rap thing, are you working on like heaps of stuff to like kind of catch up to the people that are already working?
Yeah. There's a lot of people ahead of like far in the game right now doing their thing. Yeah. A lot of rappers around the area killing it now, like 1-4. There's heaps of them killing it, you know what I mean? Curve, everyone, they're all doing good things. I'm just starting, like I've been rapping for a month now. But I dropped a clip, and a lot of people don't notice, but that first clip I done, I completed within 15 minutes. And I done that clip within an hour. And I dropped it straight away. And I rushed that, because to be completely honest, I was fucking around. I didn't expect the exposure I got. And when I got that exposure, I got all these people messaging me saying like, oh, you done well, you done good, keep it up. And then I got all the hate and things, and then my Instagram fan base started blowing up a bit. I was like, fuck, you know, I can make something of this shit. And then now I'm sitting on 3 tracks, and I've got a clip and track dropping this week that I've done with the boys in Penrith that I like and I enjoy, and hopefully it goes somewhere with this. Hopefully I can go somewhere with this.
Yeah. What would you tell these kids out there these days, man? Because now everyone is kind of like just buying a valley, put it on, go to Kmart, buy a knife and like post on Instagram, you know? What would you tell them?
Yeah, I'm not the one to talk because I fucking, I've been doing that shit. My mates all do that shit. All the boys do that shit. But I still know grown men doing all that shit. This is a lifestyle, really. Like, it's a real lifestyle. Like, sometimes it's just, you have to do that type of things. But if I could say that, anyone would say don't do it, it's not right. Like, anyone would be like, don't do it, bro. It's not a good lifestyle. But like, sometimes it's just, they have to do it. It's not a thing where they want to or not. Like, because like, 9 out of 10 people don't want to do that shit.
Why do you reckon they have to do it? Because it's like kind of separate situation, you know? There's like people that are chasing clout.
Yeah.
Because if you have to do it, you wouldn't like pose and like take a photo and put it on Instagram.
Oh, for sure, bro. I'm telling you right now, bro, the ones who post in Nines and those ones on fucking Instagram and social media websites and that, bro, they don't do any of that. They don't do any of that type of shit, bro. They're just clout chasing. The ones who don't show off with all that type of things, the ones who have that hidden that and don't talk about doing that, don't talk about drillings that, they're the ones doing real drillings. They're the ones who are out there doing that, bro. But like sometimes it's just the environment you're raised in, bro. You just have to have that type of shit.
Yeah, because like, you know, like the streets is kind of like different to the music and you kind of have to pick one, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
How would you describe like your music? What kind of category would you put it in? What category would you, because you just kind of like started rapping in that, you know?
Oh yeah, I'm to put it to some of the, like to sum it down, I'd be going towards the same way. Kick Herve, Mitchell's the Menace, you know, that type of scene. Right, you got Drill here, you got all those boys following the England path, I'm following just sticking to the Aussie scene, like you got, you know, all the boys in the Aussie scene right now, I'm just doing it with them and see where we go.
Yeah. You been in the studio heap lately?
I've been low key in the studio working with a few people. Ever since that first drop, like I said before, like I didn't expect that exposure. I didn't expect that much backlash or that much people to fucking send me messages because like within 2 days, man, people were fucking with it. And I don't think there's a rapper in Australia who's first dropped their debut clip and cop fucking close to 10,000 views. And I don't even share or expose it at all. So yeah, definitely.
Nah, yeah, but how come it was so short, that song? It felt like it was one person.
Yeah, it was a very short song actually. It was a promo clip. I was just listening to a certain person was telling me what to do pretty much, and I was fucking with it. But we had a plan, and we done it, and it was just a promo clip to get me out there, and it got me out of there. Like it got me out there. Everyone was fucking like either hating or liking it, and it got me out there. And now I'm gonna drop this next clip. Everyone's gonna be eager to hear it.
What's the name of this next song coming?
It's gonna be called The Come Up.
Yeah.
And it's got a dope clip to it. I had a few boys with me helping me out, and it's definitely 100% harder.
So this one is gonna be like your proper debut.
Yeah, definitely a proper debut. This one bangs. Like the first one, I couldn't really listen to it. Like, you know, when you hear your own voice on the phone or something, you're like, fuck, is that what it sound like? Fuck, man. Like every time I hear that song, man, I want to just shoot myself. like you got rap here and music here, and that track's over there, bro. That's not anywhere near it. But man, it is what it is, bro. I'm happy.
Yeah. When is that dropping?
I think Monday. I'm aiming for Monday.
Yeah.
Tuesday. But yeah, it'll be this week. This week.
And where did you shoot the clip at?
Done in Penrith.
Yeah. So yeah, man, is Penrith fucking with you?
Penrith's my set. I love Penrith. Yeah. You know, like when anyone talks about Penrith, my name's popping up somewhere in there.
Yeah. Definitely yours and like Kid Curve, man. Like,
yeah, definitely.
He's grinding.
He's killing it, bro. Kid Curve is going places. Like he's fucked. He come from the bottom of that ladder. Yeah. Like you see his first. You think my like first clip got hate on? You should see his first clips, man. They copped the worst of mine. But he's a good guy, a good character.
We'll work on getting him on DM him.
Yeah, definitely. There's a few lads I can speak to get you on here for you. Kid Curve, Mitchell Smez. Mitchell Smez, one guy you definitely get a fucking view with, bro.
Yeah.
He's a cool guy.
I was meant to go to a show they were doing, like, I don't know, 2 weeks back.
Oh, the Apocalypse Tour.
Yeah. I was meant to shoot some content with Alex Jones.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and then I would have, if I went there, I would have shot everything.
Yeah, definitely, yeah, nah, that's sick.
Nah, next time, I'll definitely line it up, man.
Yes, for sure, bro.
Who would you consider your favorite artist in art music or like in America?
Or
it doesn't have to be favorite, who would you want to work with? Like?
Australia based, I'd love, like, as you know, I love with Kirsten and Kick Hervé. Worldwide, my favorite rapper is fucking Hoodrich Pablo, fucking Gucci Mane, Moneybagg. Jay-Z, fuck, they're killing it, you know, the Atlanta specials, they're killing it.
For all the haters, what would you tell them to prepare for this song?
It's 110% better, but you're gonna hate it, but why? Because half of you is hating, they're just jealous. Jealous I'm doing my own thing. And I know you know what I'm fucking talking about, because you're probably gonna watch this shit. and think to yourself, he's talking about me, and you're fucking 100% right, I'm talking about you. You know who you are, but it is what it is, eh? I'll do my own thing, you do your own thing.
Hey, you can't let the haters stop you, man.
Yeah, I'm here to stay now. Like, you name one rapper who just dropped his clip and he's already in the scene, like I am. I don't mean to be cocky, but it's just the truth.
Now you have to be confident in yourself.
Yeah, you? I'm fucking 100% confident in myself. Like, the track, like I'm saying, it takes me back to the tracks I got put away now, what I'm doing clips for. If I thought those tracks were shit, if I thought those clips were going to be shit, trust me, I would have stopped at 27 film clip. I would have stopped, I would have deleted that, but I've left it there. Even though it's not good, and I wouldn't be the first to admit that, but it's still there and it's staying there because I know what I've got coming is going to be fucking good.
Yeah.
They're going to know who I am soon.
And just you telling me that, like, it shows that you're not really like, oh, everything I put out is good, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
yeah.
It's good to know that, you know what I mean? You can get better.
Oh, they're most definitely, bro. I'll be the first to say, bro. Yeah. Like, I wasn't confident about putting it out anyway, but I put it out anyway because people were waiting on it to drop.
Yeah.
I wasn't going to drop it originally. I didn't like it, but people wanted it to be dropped. So I dropped it anyway, and it's there, and fucking, I'm here now, but, you know, no one starts good. No one starts a good rapper.
Yeah.
This is how you finish, I guess. It's what you go along the lines.
Definitely, bro, you know what I mean? We all got to start from somewhere.
Yeah, fucking
hell. You know? And that's respect that you said that, you know?
Definitely, bro.
After this next track drops, what's the plans for the rest of the year?
I've got a few tracks put away at the moment that need clips done, that are really, really fucking solid tracks. Like, they're real good tracks, and I've just got to do clips for them. But pretty much my goals from here on out is, I want to be flooding the scene, videos, and clip wise, and music wise. I want to be like on every corner of platforms. I want to be on Spotify and that, like just certain platforms like that, like what the other boys are doing in that. And by New Year's Eve, I just want to be like fucking pretty much up there, I guess. Not like fucking at the top, but fucking close to it.
Yeah. And it's important, but like content is important. Actually,
yeah. Yeah, definitely. I've noticed that. Like the quality of the photos or videos you post, it all needs to be up there.
Yeah.
And I'm on the right track though. I'm not the best, but fucking, you know, I'm only gonna get better.
Yeah. Now, yeah. Could we look forward to like a show anytime soon?
Yeah, definitely. I've got plans for that. It'll be in the new year. 2020 is gonna be a big year for me. Pretty much from here on out to the end of the year, I'm building a platform. My following base is building up. It's getting. I'm getting people messaging me on a daily basis now. I've got a clothing brand coming out soon.
What's the name of the clothing brand?
It's going to be Hood and Rich.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, it's pretty gangster. It's pretty much the boys in the hood logo, but it's going to be Hood and Rich.
Yeah.
And anyone wants to try a copy, it's already made, it's already done, so it's right there. I'm just waiting for a release date, so he can't buy shit.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's going to drop at the end of the year, pretty much. I have a website and that being currently made for it. So it's going to be dope too, but 2020 is going to be my year. I'm going to aim for some shows now. Maybe opening up some shows with some big people too, so it'll be good.
Yeah.
I won't say a few, but it's going to happen.
Could you give a little DM exclusive?
I think we already know, you just turned that off. Nah, it'd be good.
Hey, that's mad, bro. Like, you know what I mean? We're definitely looking forward to it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, he's gonna see me around a lot.
It seems like we're focused and like in the music field.
Yeah, definitely. Like, fuck, man, just seeing the way other people are doing it now, I'm learning off other people. Yeah. And I wouldn't call it copying. I'm just watching other people move. You know, I'm not talking. I'm just, you know, just listening and watching and just fucking letting it happen and watching how they move. And I'll do the same thing. And it's working. Everything's working for me now. Everything's going well.
Yeah. Now, yeah, bro. Who would you give a shout out to?
Right now. Fuck. Kid Curvey, Cursor, fucking all the rappers doing it, bro. I'm killing it from every area, pretty much, eh? I'm not, you know, we're all on our own paths. There's a lot of people at war right now, but fuck, it is what it is, eh? But everyone's on their own path, everyone's killing it. Shout out to all the areas and fucking all the boys in there, huh?
Yeah,
fucking up.
Shout out Western Sydney.
Shout out to Western Sydney, fuck any other fucking district, you know?
Because just, right now, if people outside of Australia, if they listen to music coming out of Australia, it's definitely coming from like Western Sydney.
Yeah, fuck no. No one's doing it like Western Sydney. No other state in Australia is doing it like Western Sydney, eh? They all doing their own thing. But there's no one doing it like Western Sydney. And at least Western Sydney can fucking say when the time comes when Australia's on the map, like proper, like, you know how everyone listens to American music. But when we got other countries listening to Australian music, no one can fucking say they've done it other than Western Sydney.
Yeah.
Western Sydney, but even in the fight game and that, you know, you've got Tuatua Vasa, UFC fighters and that. Bro, you'll see like Western Sydney boys in UFC, NRL, like we're fucking killing. The game, Western Sydney's the top.
Shout out Western Sydney, bro.
Fuck no.
Is this your first interview you ever done?
Yeah, first interview, aye.
Yeah,
not bad. Hey, shout out to you, bro, for giving me the chance to do it. fucking oath, eh?
So
we sure to get some boys on for
that. Yeah, that was good, bro. You know what I mean? We're just trying to make a scene up for ourselves as well.
Yeah,
know?
Definitely. No, 100%. We'll definitely get that happening.
Like, the whole music thing is happening.
Yeah.
We're trying to get our media stuff going.
Yeah, fucking you know I mean? Perfect time to do it, bro. The Australian scene's popping.
It's just all these haters stop copying.
Leave it to DME, eh?
DME TV.
Yeah, fuck any other music out there, huh?
Yes, sir. Nahuru, bro, it was a pleasure talking to you, man.
Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate that.
We'll definitely look forward to like working with you in the future, you know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure. You'll see me back one day, bro.
We'll definitely do a better interview one day.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
For sure, bro.
When you're platinum, you know what I mean?
Yeah, fucking.
When you're on tour.
I'll pick you up in a fucking limo, lad.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we'll get it out there, bro. All the haters suck these nuts, lad.
Yeah.
It's gonna be that, brother.
Shout out to you, bro. Shout out to Penrith. Yeah, shout out to Western Sydney. Shout out to 27th District.
Yeah, fuck, man.
Shout out all the districts.
Shout out, shout out to every fucking. Actually, not every district. Just shout out to all the fucking boys, like.
Yeah.
Shout out to fucking Penrith, bro.
Nah, yeah.
Alright, it's fun.
Nah, all good, bro. Thanks for inviting us to your area.
Too easy, bro.